Hello students, today we are going to learn chemical properties of hydrogen. So hydrogen how reacting with the other compounds. The same way all the isotopes of hydrogen how reacting with the other compounds. That is called chemical property of hydrogen. So first we are going to learn about the protium. Three isotopes of hydrogen we know. Protium, tritium, deuterium. Right, the protium, normal hydrogen we are using, no? How, which is reacting with other things. Hydrogen, what is the symbol of hydrogen? H, right? The first chemical property of this hydrogen is nothing but reaction with the water. Sorry, reaction with the oxygen, it will give water. Hydrogen reacted with the oxygen gives water. We may think just forming water only, but it is an explosive violent reaction, right? Formation of water is a violent reaction. Next, hydrogen reacting with halogens. First reaction with oxygen, next with halogens. Halogens means, what are halogens? Simply halogen we will denote with X. X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and then iodine. Hydrogen react with this above halogen. What will happen? H2X2 will give 2HX. The place of X2 we can apply this fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. For example, I am writing H2 is treated with Cl2. So, we will get 2HCl. Suppose, if you use the hydrogen with bromine, what is the product? 2HBr. Same way, you can write for fluorine as well as iodine. But, we have the condition, right? So, in different condition, different halogens are reacting with hydrogen. For example, fluorine is reacting violently or vigorously, even the DAR. Okay, listen carefully. Fluorine react with hydrogen in the DAR condition itself. Right? At the same time, chlorine react at a room temperature. Then bromine, light with heating. The last, iodine is reacted as a photochemical reaction. Okay, my students, even though X, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine may occupy the place of X, but which forming the hydrogen halide, HX, in different condition. So, HCl, HF, HBr, HI, everything we can form with different conditions, right? Yes. If you see the charge of hydrogen in these reactions, H plus, because if you dissociate this HCl, it will give H plus and Cl minus. So, what's the charge of hydrogen here? Plus 1. Plus means plus 1. Why I am saying here, the next reaction will learn H minus, that's why. Okay. Next, the hydrogen is reacted with some metals like sodium. Next reaction, first hydrogen reacts with oxygen, second hydrogen, next metals. What are the metals? It may be lithium, sodium, calcium like metals, right? Hydrogen reacting with sodium, lithium, calcium like metals. It's forming hydrides. Okay. How will you write the equation? Hydrogen react with lithium. 2 lithium. It will give lithium hydride. The same way hydrogen react with sodium. It will produce sodium hydride. So, in these cases, the product lithium hydride, sodium hydride, the hydrogen having the minus 1 charge because lithium will ionize into lithium plus and then H minus. Here the hydrogen having minus one charge. So H plus means we will say proton. H minus means we will say hydride. That's why I told in the previous reaction with halogen, which forming as a H plus one plus oxidation state with the metals which acting as a minus one oxidation state. Right? Important thing, this lithium hydride, sodium hydride, like hydrogen with metal, that hydrides acting as a reducing agent. They are acting as a reducing agent. You may ask doubt, what do you mean reducing agent? Right? So it will undergo oxidation. It will help for some other thing. Some other will reduce. Okay? So they will act as a reducing agent. It will undergo oxidation. Then the lithium hydride and sodium hydride, which is used to prepare important reducing agent like lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride. Now we are going to prepare lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride. For that we have to take lithium hydride 4 times with aluminium chloride, AlCl3. So it will form lithium aluminium hydride, LiAlH4. It is the molecular formula for lithium aluminium hydride. How it forms in this? Among the 4 lithium, 1 lithium we have taken, 1 aluminium, and then 4 hydrogen. What are the remaining things? 3 lithium, 3 chlorine. So we can write 3 lithium chloride. Then sodium hydride also react with boron methoxide, boron trimethoxide. CH3O is called methoxide group. 3 times means trimethoxide. So boron trimethoxide will give sodium borohydride. Both are important reducing agent. What are the remaining things? 3 sodium, then 3 methoxide group. It will form sodium methoxide. What's the name of this compound? Sodium methoxide. Listen, my dear students. Metals react with hydrogen giving hydrides. By using that hydrides, we can prepare very important reducing agent. Lithium aluminum hydride and sodium borohydride. Next, we are going to learn the hydrogen itself acting as a reducing agent. See, hydrogen react with metals produce as a reducing agent. Here, the hydrogen itself acting as a reducing agent. For organic compound, the synthetic preparation of organic compound. Organic compound means a made up of hydrogen and carbon. Like acetylene, CH triple bond CH is called acetylene. It is also called ethyne, which is treated with hydrogen in the presence of finely divided nickel. Finely divided means pieces of nickel. The mixture is taken as a catalyst. Now what will happen? From these two hydrogen, one will add in the first carbon, another one will add in the next carbon. So the triple bond becoming single bond. So what are the product, my dear students? CH2 double bond CH2. Now we are reduced one bond. That's why which is acting as a reducing agent. Then same reaction further proceed means what will happen? One more hydrogen will add in the each carbon. One hydrogen in the first carbon, another hydrogen in the second carbon. So what are the product, my dear students? CH3 single bond CH3. Why? One more bond will reduce because we have added each carbon, each one hydrogen. What's the name of this compound? Acetylene. This compound ethylene. This compound ethane. Right? In the organic compound, when we will learn the organic compound, at the time we will learn how to give the IUPAC name for all the organic compounds. Right? Next,
we are going to learn how the deuterium is reacting with oxygen and halogen. Okay, so the deuterium, what's the symbol of deuterium? D. How the deuterium is reacting with the halogen? First we will say oxygen. Deuterium also reacting like hydrogen with O2 gives D2O two times. The same way with halogens it will form DX. X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and then iodine. Okay, yes, apart from this, as usual, hydrogen and deuterium for going with the same type of reaction. The special type of reaction for deuterium is it can replace the hydrogen. Already in particular compound hydrogen is present, that hydrogen can be replaced by this deuterium. So replaceable reaction. So in that we will take methane CH4 reacted with the deuterium. What will happen? This 4 hydrogen is replaced by this deuteron. So CD4 and 2H2 will form. Now the deuterium replaced the place of hydrogen. The same way ammonia NH3 also replaced. Right? This 6 hydrogen, 2 into 3, 6 hydrogen will be replaced with 3 deuterium. So the deuterium will replace the place of hydrogen. So what will happen? The product is 2ND3 and the other product is 3H2. Now look at the board, my dear students. Here deuterium undergoing same type of reaction with the hydrogen. Hydrogen gives water with the oxygen and the hydrogen halides also form. The same way deuterium react with oxygen gives heavy water. Here we can know that another thing, this is also called heavy water. Why it is called heavy water? See, the deuterium also called heavy hydrogen. H means hydrogen, D means heavy hydrogen. That's why D2O called heavy water. Then replaceable reaction with the methane and ammonia. Now the last isotope, what's the last isotope of hydrogen? Tritium. What's the symbol for tritium, my dear students? T. Tritium. Tritium undergoes emission of a beta particle, because which is not an ordinary chemical reaction, it is a nuclear reaction. So it will, which will emit the beta particle. First we must know what is alpha particle. Fast moving alpha, bundle of 2 proton, 2 neutron is called alpha particle. Then what is beta particle? Fast moving electron is called beta particle. This tritium 1D3 will undergo the photochemical reaction, that means nuclear reaction. It will give helium isotope with emission of a beta particle. This is only called a beta particle. And also one more information is given. The half-life period of tritium is 12.3 years. Half-life period of tritium is 12.3 years. That means what, sir? See, if you take you know radium like compound during the dark time, we can see some shining or a glare from that. Okay, some light we may use in the night time. We may stick that star everything in that roof, you know, night time. If you switch off all the light, you can see the stars. Okay, because of radium action. Okay, that is an example for nuclear reaction. So nuclear reaction will not depends upon the any reactor or product. Automatically it will emit the particles. Okay, the same way here also nuclear reaction, it will emit the continuously beta particle. So when the half of the tritium will undergo the reaction means 12.3 years, that is only called half life period. Now we are going to learn the uses of hydrogen. What are the uses of the hydrogen? First uses, hydrogen mostly used to prepare the synthetic application. What do you mean synthetic application? We will prepare artificially some compounds, you know, for that we need hydrogen, right? So one of the familiar method is Haber process. First uses we are using to prepare synthetic chemicals like ammonia. The name of the product process is Haber's process. The Haber process will prepare the ammonia. N2 plus 3H2 will give 2NH3. This NH3 only called ammonia. See, the ammonia preparation is called Haber process. What are the condition? We have to maintain the temperature 380 degree Celsius to 450 degree Celsius. Then 200 atmosphere pressure you want to maintain. The catalyst we have to keep iron. Then what's the use of this ammonia? By using this ammonia we can prepare nitric acid, fertilizer, and also we can use that explosive materials. Okay, then second uses of hydrogen. What's the second use of hydrogen? We can prepare the organic solvent like industrial solvent. What do you mean solvent? Some chemical we are using to dissolve anything means that is called solvent. Water is a good solvent. Why? We are dissolving the anything by using the water. Okay. So for example, if you want to dissolve salt, what will you do? You will add the water. So water is one of the best solvent. The same way industry, we want to dissolve something, we will use some solvent. One of the example for industrial solvent is methanol. So we are going to prepare the methanol by using hydrogen. Hydrogen is treated with carbon monoxide. It gives methanol. Right? 4 hydrogen, 3 plus 1, 4 hydrogen. What's the name of the compound? Methanol. We can prepare the methanol. Then what's the third use? Third use is nothing but we can unsaturated compound to saturated oils. Unsaturated oils means what? Which may have the double bond or triple bond. Unsaturated fatty acid. Unsaturated fatty oils can be converted into saturated unsaturated fatty oil can be converted into saturated fats is called vanaspati. See my dear students, you will see, no, you will say, no, vanaspati ghee, like a vanaspati, we will say, you know, one dalda. Okay, that like oils we can prepare by using hydrogen, right? Unsaturated fatty oils with saturated fats we can prepare, that is only called vanaspati. The presence of catalyst platinum and hydrogen. What's the catalyst we got to use? Unsaturated fatty oil can be converted into saturated fats by using the catalyst platinum. Important, we are learning uses of hydrogen, you know, that only called hydrogen. So we are using as a catalyst here. Then what's the fourth uses? Metal oxides can be converted into metals. Like copper oxide, CuO, copper oxide, you can convert into copper. Then another metal, tungsten, W is nothing but tungsten with hydrogen, 3 hydrogen, 3 oxygen, it will form 3 moles of water, then tungsten. Listen. Copper oxide, tungsten oxide, metal oxides are converted into metals and water. In this reaction, we are using the hydrogen gas. The next one is fifth uses.
Atomic hydrogen and oxyhydrogen. What do you mean oxyhydrogen, my dear students? Oxyhydrogen means hydrogen with the oxygen. Oxyhydrogen, okay. Used in welding and cutting torch. Okay, we will use some fuel, some light to cut the weld, some rod as well as in the welding process. That gas we can use as a hydrogen or oxyhydrogen gases. Okay, which is used in the torch, right, for cutting and welding. Then liquid hydrogen, liquid state hydrogen, used as a fuel in rocket fuel. We will say, you know, white petrol, okay, rocket, okay, like liquid hydrogen used as a fuel in the rocket. The last uses, hydrogen is used as a fuel in rechargeable batteries. In the rechargeable batteries also we can use the hydrogen, because some metal having the reversible retake, okay, for example metals can absorb hydrogen as well as it will release hydrogen. By using this nature of hydrogen and metal, we can prepare metal hydride batteries, rechargeable metal hydride batteries. Yes, my dear students, we have completed uses of hydrogen. Now we are going to learn about the compounds of hydrogen. So by using the hydrogen we can prepare many compounds. One of the important compounds we know, that water. So we are going to learn about water. What's the molecular formula for water, my dear students? Yes, H2O, right? So hydrogen, by using the hydrogen, one of the big most familiar or which one having the more number of hydrogen, that is water, right? Okay, in the earth 70% we have the water as a ocean, right? In the ozone, that water, right, 70% water we have in the earth surface, right? But which is not drinkable, which is having some salt along with that. Because of that we cannot be able to drink, but which having the hydrogen. Then however, the sea water contains many dissolved salt, right, which having the hydrogen. Because of which having the hydrogen, which is having the more percentage in the water. Then which are also essential for living things, okay, which is essential for living things like animals and humans, okay. Then plants also, living things essential for water. Water is essential for living organisms. At last, human body itself having 65% of water. Human body, see, sea water 75% of earth surface, 65% our human body having the water, right? What's the structure of water? See, usually H2O can be write hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen. That means what? One side hydrogen, another side hydrogen, middle we have the oxygen. But which is not like linear structure, which is forming bent structure. So this also important, that angle between these two covalent bond is 104.5 degree. This is oxygen, hydrogen, and also another hydrogen. Next, physical properties. As you know, which is not having any color, then if you heat, it can be converted into steam. So we can say volatile nature. One of the peculiar case of that hydrogen is condensation. Condensation means a combined nature. If you take one water, another water, how they are connected between them, because of intermolecular hydrogen bond. Intermolecular hydrogen bond means what? Bond between the two water molecules. Because of this reason we have the liquid water, otherwise we may not be have the liquid water. every water may be in a gaseous state. So liquid water exists because of intermolecular hydrogen bond. That is a peculiar case. And also because of this intermolecular hydrogen bond, which having high melting point as well as boiling point, right? The remaining they are given in the table. We can go through the tables, right? Chemical properties of that hydrogen, we will see that water, we will see the next class. Thank you.